Hello students, welcome to the next class of trigonometry. So in the previous sections, that is part 1 and part 2, so we have learnt about the trigonometric ratios, and in part 2 we have done one example, right? Now we are going to do more examples and exercise problems. Okay, so today just see the example which I am going to explain now. For more interesting videos, please subscribe my channel and touch the bell beside it to get notifications. So the question is, now consider triangle ACB, right angled at C, in which AB is equal to 29 units, BC is equal to 21 units, and angle ABC is equal to theta. Then determine the first one, cos square theta plus sin square theta. Second is cos square theta minus sin square theta. So here the triangle is given as ACB. So to solve any problem in trigonometry, so we have to draw triangle, the figure, so that we can easily solve the question, isn't it? So that's why first we have to draw the figure, that is triangle ACB. Okay, here this is triangle ACB, and here it is said the right angle at C. It means that here it should be C and here it is ACB. Is it okay? Right. And given that AB is equal to 29 units, AB is equal to 29 units. So AB, this is, which is nothing but what side is this? As it is opposite to right angle, this is hypotenuse, right? And BC is equal to 21. So this is BC and this is 21 units. Okay, so in this triangle we know the two sides, that is given in the question. But what about AC? Yes, we had to consider, we had to determine this, we had to find out the value of the side AC. And moreover, in the question it is given angle ABC is equal to theta, means the angle B is theta. So hence here I am writing theta. At B it is theta angle, right? So here first let us find AC, then after we will get the values of cos and sin, then we will find out the values. Okay, so here first we are going to find the value of AC, right? So here from the figure, from triangle ACB, by Pythagoras theorem, isn't it? So what is that? Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square, that is AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square, AC square plus BC square, right? Now we don't know AC, so hence we are going to find out AC square. So to get AC square, I am bringing or sending plus BC square this side. What happens? AB square, if it comes this side, it will be BC square is equal to what is left on the right side? AC square, right? Now I am writing this on left side and this is right side. So AC square is equal to AB square minus BC square, right? From which we get the value of AC. Now substitute the values of AB. What is AB here? AB is 29 units. So 29 square minus what is BC? BC is 21. So 21 square. So here, what is the value of 29 square? It is, let us find here in the rough, okay. So here it is 29 into 29. 9 9s are 81, 9 2s are 18, 18 8, 26. And 2 9s are 18, 2 to the 4 and 5. So 1, 8, 6, 14. It is 841, right? So 29 square is 841. Minus 21 square, it is obviously 441. Okay. Now what is the value of the difference between 841 minus 441? 41 minus 41, 0. So 800 minus 400 will be 400. Okay, Now what we got? AC square is equal to 400. Then what is the value of AC? AC is equal to square root of 400 will be equal to 20, right? Because square root of 400 is 20. Hence we got AC value is as 20, right? Now what we had to find? We had to find cos theta and sin theta. So after finding, we can substitute the values in this one, and in this one we will get the answer, right? Now first we had to find the value of cos theta. Here theta is where? Here. Okay, then this side will be opposite side and this side will be adjacent side, right? Why this is opposite? Because it is opposite to the angle, right? Now what is the formula for cos theta? It is adjacent by hypotenuse, isn't it? Okay, I'm writing adjacent side by hypotenuse. Okay, now what is adjacent side here? This is adjacent side to this. Hence I'm writing it is 21 by hypotenuse is 29. So we got cos theta, how much? 21 by 29. Okay, now we have to find sin theta value. Okay, so sin theta, what is the formula for sin theta? Yes, opposite by hypotenuse. So what is opposite? It is 20 by hypotenuse, 29. So as we got cos theta value and sin theta value, we will find the values, the first one and second one, right? So here the first one, what is that? Cos square theta minus, sorry, plus sin square theta, right, is equal to cos square theta. What is cos theta? 21 by 29 whole square plus, what is sin theta? Sin theta is 20 by 29, right? So 20 by 29 whole square is equal to 21 square by 29 square. So what is the value of 21 square? Already we know it is 441 and 29 square is 841. So it is 841 plus, here 20 square means 400 by 29 square means 841. Got it? Is equal to, what is the LCM? As denominators are same, hence we will take one denominator and we will add this. So what are that? What are those? 441 plus 400. How much it will be? 441 and 400 will be 841. Right? This and this get cancelled, then the answer is 1. Okay? Right. Now we are going to find the value of cos square theta minus sin square theta, right? Which is second one. So cos square theta minus sin square theta is equal to, cos theta is how much? 21 by 29. So 21 by 29 whole square minus sin theta square means 20 by 29 whole square. So 21 square means how much it is? It is 441 by 29 square means already we got it is 841 minus 20 square means 400 by 29 square means 841. Here also same, LCM is 841 and as minus sign is there, we have to subtract 400 from 441. So 441 minus 400, how much it is? 41, right? So this is the answer. So this is the first one, this is the second one. So like this we can solve the problems easily if we know the trigonometric ratios. Okay, now we will go to the exercise problems and we will solve the problems. Okay, now we are going to take exercise problems. Okay students, now exercise, the first problem here, the question is, in triangle ABC, right angle at B and AB is equal to 24 centimeters, BC is equal to 7 centimeters. Determine the first one, sin A cos A, and second, sin C cos C. Okay, now shall we solve this? Yes, yeah, let us proceed. Now the solution, as I said, to solve any problem, what we have to draw, what we have to do first? Yes, we have to draw the figure first. Okay, right. Now, as A, B, C, so hence right angle at B means we can easily draw the diagram like this. Here, so here A, B, C, so right angle at B. Okay. Now, what the values are given? AB is equal to 24. This is AB is equal to 24 centimeters, and BC is 7 centimeters. So we have to find this. But do we know AC? No. What is AC? It is nothing but hypotenuse. Okay. So first we have to find the value of AC. Then after we will get the values of sin A cos A and sin C cos C. Right. So let us find the value of AC. How do you find the value of AC in a right angled triangle? Yes, from Pythagoras theorem. Right. So here we are writing in triangle ABC, we write directly as AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Or you can write since Pythagoras theorem. Right, it is Pythagoras theorem. Now directly we are going to find AC value. AC square is equal to, because we know AB value and BC value, substitute the values. So AB is how much? In place of AB, we'll write 24 square plus, in place of BC, we write 7 square. Okay, na? Right. Now, what is the square of 24 square? Value of 24? It is nothing but 24 into 24. It is 576. Even you can find in rough by multiplying 24 into 24. Okay. Plus 7 square is how much? It is 49. Got it? Yeah. Now, plus we have to add both of them. So 9 plus 6, 15, 1, 7 plus 1, 8, 8, 4, 12, 1, 5, 1, 6. So it is 625. We got AC square value as 625. We need only AC. So it will be square root of 625. So what is the value of 625? It is 25. Right? So we got AC is equal to 25. Hence I am writing here 25. Okay, after finding AC, simply we will get the values of first sin A. So sin A means the what is the angle here? Reference angle is A. Where it is in the figure? Here. So be careful while finding the values, because which angle is taken here, according to that we have to find the sine the trigonometric ratios. Okay, as A is taken here, then which will be the opposite side? Yes, this will be the opposite side, because this side is opposite to angle A, and hypotenuse is hypotenuse, and this will be adjacent when we consider A. Okay, right. Now for sin A, we know for sin A the formula is opposite side by hypotenuse, right? So opposite side by hypotenuse in the figure, what is opposite to sin A? A, that is BC. What is the hypotenuse? AC is equal to, what is BC value? 7. What is AC value? Yes, 25. So we got sin A is equal to 7 by 25. Okay. Now cos A. You know cos A formula, that is adjacent side by hypotenuse. So here, what is adjacent side with reference to A? So here this is the angle, and this is, okay, as this is opposite, and this will be adjacent side, that is AB. So adjacent side, how much it is? 24. So it is 24 by what is hypotenuse? Yes, it is 25. So hence we got the cos A value as 24 by 25. Okay, so first over, now second we are going to find out. So that is sin C. So here be careful. Here we are going to find sine C. So what is the reference angle? Yes, C here. Now when you consider C, then what happens? Yes, this will be the opposite side. Got it? And this will be the adjacent. So here it is hypotenuse. Now what is the formula for sine C? Already sine we write opposite by hypotenuse. But according to, with reference to C, what is the opposite side? AB, right? So hence I am writing AB by hypotenuse is AC, right? Okay. So what is AB value? AB value is 24. By what is AC value? 25. Yes. So we got sine C is 24 by 25. Right. Now next cos C. So cos C is what the formula? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. Right. So with reference to angle C, this is the adjacent BC and hypotenuse AC. So that's why BC by AC is equal to what is BC? 7. Right. By what is AC? 25. So finish. So like this we can easily solve the problems. So no need to worry about trigonometry. It is very easy if you learn trigonometric ratios. Do you feel as it is easy? Easy or not? Yes. Okay. So once please understand and do practice and try to solve the new problem, then you will get the confidence to solve the new problems. But you must learn the formulae, right? And the method, you have to follow the method. Got it? Yes. So dear students, here we have another problem. Here in the question, the figure is given. In figure, find tan P minus cot R. So this is the figure, triangle PQR. Okay, PQR, PQ is given 12 centimeters and PR is given 13 centimeters. So it is asked to find the value of tan P minus cot R. So here, okay, you know the trigonometric ratio tan is equal to opposite side by adjacent side and cot adjacent side by opposite. But here the value of QR is not known, right? Yes. How do you find? Yes, from Pythagoras theorem, right? Now, so directly we are solving like this. From triangle PQR, what do we write? By Pythagoras theorem, what is hypotenuse square? That is PR square is equal to side square PQ square plus side square, that is QR square. So what do you have to find? QR square, right? Then what I write, I will send PQ square that side, left side, that is PR square already there. If it comes this side, it will be minus PQ square is equal to what is left? Yes, QR square. So I am making this as subject. I am writing on the left side, that is QR square is equal to this. I will write on the right side, that is PR square minus PQ square. So children, please, students, please concentrate. I can write direct step, but to make you understand, I am writing like this. Okay? Yes. If you know the all the steps, you can go directly. So simply, you can write directly from the figure, that is QR square is equal to PR square minus PQ square, and substitute the values, you will get the value of QR. Okay? Yes. Now what is the value of PR? PR. Yes, this is PR, 13 square. So 13 square minus what is PQ? PQ, it is 12. So 12 square, right? Now what is the square of 13? Yes, it is 169 minus what is the value of 12? 12 into 12, 144. Yes. And what is the value of 169 minus 144? If 144 is subtracted 169 from 169, it will be 25. So what you are finding actually? QR square. Okay, and here I'll write, I'll continue from this side. So we got QR is equal to, so if you remove the square, it will become square root for 25. So that will be how much? Yes, very good, 5. So you got QR is equal to 5. Okay, so we have to get the value of this. So first we have to find tan P, right? Tan P is equal to tan P capital, this is. Okay, so the reference angle is P. Yes, this is. Okay, now if you take this angle, what will be the opposite side? Yes, QR will be the opposite side, and this will be hypotenuse as it is opposite to right angle. Obviously, this will be adjacent. Okay, so this will be QR will be opposite side and PQ will be adjacent side. So we know tan P is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. You can directly write even. What is opposite side to P? That is QR by PQ. So what is QR? QR is 5. What is PQ? PQ is 12. So this is tan P. Okay. So what we have to find more? Cot R, right? So cot R, be careful, the angle is changed, R. Here this is the R. Now reference angle is R. Then what happens? This will be opposite side PQ and this will be QR. So that's why in the first class I told you that be careful which angle you are considering. So depending on the angle, the sides will change, especially opposite and adjacent only change, hypotenuse will not change, right? Yes, coming to this point. So what is the opposite side to the R angle? PQ, right? So PQ, actually what is the formula for cot R? Cot adjacent by opposite side, right? What is the adjacent side? QR, right? So QR by, so QR by what? PQ. Got it? Once I repeat, for the cot we have the formula adjacent side by opposite side. So this is the adjacent side QR and opposite is PQ, right? What is the value of QR? It is 5. What is PQ? 12. Yes, so same value we got. Hence, therefore tan P minus cot R is equal to tan P value we got 5 by 12 minus cot R value we got 5 by 12 is equal to 0, right? Okay, ma? Okay. Now we'll solve the other problem. That is the last one today. So another problem. Given sec theta is equal to 13 by 12 and asked to calculate all other trigonometric ratios. Easy, right? We have to construct the triangle, right angled triangle, then obviously we'll get the values. Okay. Yes. So simply triangle. Here ABC is not given, we can write ourselves ABC triangle. This is right angle at B, but theta is given, hence I am taking theta here. Okay, then what happens? This is the reference angle, which is acute only. So this is opposite side and this is adjacent side. This will be hypotenuse, right? Okay, so given, what is given? Sec theta is equal to 13 by 12. Okay, so but actually what is sec theta from the figure? But sec theta is equal to, yes, do you know it is a reciprocal of cos theta, right? That is yes, hypotenuse by adjacent side, right? So what is hypotenuse? AC by adjacent is what? BC. Okay, so this will be equal to how much? 13 by 12. Okay, so hence if AC is equal to 13k and BC is equal to 12k, where k is a positive number. We did the same problem in the part 2, right? Do you remember? Okay. So now what is next? Yeah. So we had to find, we got AC is equal 13K. Here I am writing 13K and BC is equal 12K. This is 12K. Then we had to find AB. Yes. So from Pythagoras theorem. From Pythagoras theorem, we have AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, right? But what do we need? AB square. Hence, AB square, here AC square, I am bringing plus BC square, then it happens BC square, okay? Simple, I am leaving AB square on the right side, but I am sending BC square towards left, hence it is become minus. That's why AC square minus BC square is equal to AB square, okay? Here I am writing properly. Yes. So here, actually, what we have to write? AB square is equal to this writing on right side minus BC square. This is writing left side and this is writing on right side. Clear? Okay. Now we have to substitute the values. So AB square, AB square is equal to AC square. What is AC? 13 K whole square minus BC square. Okay. What is BC square? 12 K, right? So 12 K whole square. You see here, AB square is equal to AC square minus BC square. AC is 13K minus BC is 12K from the figure. Okay. Now is equal to 13 square me 13 K square means 13 square and K square. It will be 169 K square minus 12 K square means it is 144 K square. So 169 minus 144, it will be 25 K square. What you are finding? AB square. Okay. So, but AB is equal to square root of 25 K square. Why? You are sending square, that side it will be square root. So, it will be 5, 25, square root of 25 is 5 and square root of K square is K. So, you got AB is equal to 5 K. Clear? Okay. Then what is the question I asked? Calculate all other trigonometric ratios. Okay. Now first we will write the other trigonometric ratios . So first sine theta, you know that opposite by hypotenuse for sine theta, right? What is opposite to theta? AB by hypotenuse AC. So I am writing AB by AC. What is AB? 5K by AC, 13K. So KK get cancelled, it will be 5 by 13. Clear? Okay. Now next, cos. So cos theta is the reciprocal of sec theta only. It will be, if it is 13 by 12, and it will be 12 by 13. Clear? Then we will write tan theta. Yes, tan theta is nothing but, yes, opposite side by adjacent side. What is opposite to theta? That is AB. By adjacent is BC. So what is AB value? 5K. By BC value? 12K. So tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent side. So opposite side is AB and adjacent side is BC. Right? That's why AB by BC. And what is the value of AB? So AB is 5K. And BC value is 12K. Yes, 5K by 12K. KK get cancelled and it will be 5 by 12. Okay, so we got sine, cos, tan, sec. Then remaining what? Yes, cot theta, right? So cot theta will be reciprocal of tan theta. That is 1 by tan theta is equal to, so 1 by 5 by 12 that is equal to 5 by 12 becomes 12 by 5. Okay, and last is cosec theta, right? So what is cosec theta? Reciprocal of sine theta. Reciprocal of sine theta. So 1 by what is sine theta? Sine theta we got 5 by 13. So 5 by 13 means it will become 13 by 5. So like this we can easily find the trigonometric ratios like this. Okay, already we did in the second part. So the other here we done. Okay, so please continue watching my channel, and if you have any doubts please write in comment section, right? And if you want any other problems, write to me, then I will solve for you and I will upload for you. Okay, so thank you for watching.